I resemble that remark. I mean, it's like every week when I get up here to give a talk, it's like, how do you describe the undescribable, right? That place that we want to get to where we are constantly at one with the one, the divine, that force, that energy that sustains us all. So what I have to say is that it doesn't stop ministers from trying, right? And so usually that's how we fill the space, is trying to describe what cannot be described. And we break it down into smaller and smaller portions to be able to have an experience of it here on Sunday. And that's exactly how my journey in Unity happened as well. I remember clearly it was 1988, 89, and I was studying in New York City, studying A Course in Miracles, and studying the work of Louise Hay, and found Unity in Eric Butterworth, the Eric Butterworth Church in New York City. And the experience on Sunday was so profound. It was like nothing I had ever experienced before in a church or in a spiritual setting, and it set me on this journey. And I was so new and so a beginner. And then I went and took all the classes, and I went through life, and then I ended up in ministerial school, and now I'm the senior minister, and it always serves me to go back to the beginning. In fact, Steve Jobs has a quote that I ran across this week that said, "The enormous weight of success was mitigated when I had to start all over again and could just be a beginner." And it's like, oh, that weight of when we think we've got it, and then when we think we know what we're talking about, can in an instant be alleviated when we slip into beginner's mind. And then there was another quote I found that I really resonated with. This is, the first step towards getting somewhere is to decide you're not going to stay where you are. Right? And I think that's very, very prescient. J.P. Morgan had no idea what we'd be going through in this moment, right? But I have felt, I have listened to, I have been with you all in the angst of now, the worry, the pain, the exasperation, the grief of what we're all living through in this pandemic, what we've been living through for a year and a half. And we won't even go into what happened before then that might have had us, some of us, in traumatic shock. But here we are, and we keep showing up, at least I do, keep showing up every day and trying the same thing again. And I really do feel it's time that we really let go and commit to changing us first. Stop looking at everything on the outside and what everyone else should do, and change something that's within us. So I'm going to ask the music team to provide us a song about this, about how truly to become a beginner again, we have to let go and change.
Look at me. Look at me. I am trying every way I can. I am changing. I'll be better than I am. I'm trying. to find a way to understand. But I need you, I need a hand. I am changing. I'm seeing everything so clear. I am changing. I'm gonna start right now, right here. And I'm hoping it out, and I know that I can, but I need you. Walking down that long road, and there was nothing that I could find. All those years of darkness can make a person blind, but now I can see I am changing. I'm trying every way I can. I am changing. I need a friend to help me start all over again. Oh, that would be just fine, 'cause I know it's gonna work out this time. Yes, 'cause this time I am, yeah. This time I'll get my life together now. I am changing. Yes, I know how I'm gonna start again, and I'm gonna leave my past behind. I'll change my
Miss Miso Malone and her incredible band. Woo! Thank you, Misa. Wow, if ever a song could encapsulate a whole talk, that's it. Right? Whew. That place of discomfort, that place where we don't know how to handle what's actually going on, is actually the place, the bridge that transforms us. And I put it this way: nothing in life is predetermined or predestined, right? Do you get that? There's not a plan that God has where he micromanages everything that's happening on earth. A diagnosis is not a gift from God to make you wake up. It is a result of your own thinking in your own environment and the things that are happening on planet Earth. What God is, what I describe as God, what you might call spirit, what you might call universe, is the energy and the life force and the infinite possibilities that you can transcend a diagnosis. That you are bigger, the truth, that you are bigger than a diagnosis,
in the knowing that there is always another way. For there is no limit in God. There's no limit in spirit. There is no lack of time. There's no lack of resources. There's no lack of possibilities. The challenges you're experiencing right here and right now, when you can accept them and move into them, launch you into the new possibilities. The challenges right now of COVID, where you all had to show a vaccination card to come in here today. Well, that's something new that happened this week. And what will that create in this space? Right? What does that possibility, when we show that we're aligned with that understanding of healing and wholeness and sacred safety, taking everyone's highest and best into account, what does that create here in this environment? What does that create for all of us? The healthcare workers who are sitting here, the school teachers who are sitting here, the mental health professionals that are sitting in this room, the parents that are sitting in this room, and the grandparents, as we all take care of the whole global village. That's no small thing, what we're doing. It is huge, and it is life-changing for the planet. We have this infinite gift of this vaccine, of the modern miracle. The miracle that is a gift, it is an opportunity of the divine exploding right here on the planet. And it is our choice, like everything in life, to accept it or not. The universe, God, is constantly providing everything we need, saying, here it is. And our thinking, our beliefs, our faith, determines whether we'll say yes or no to the good that's there. Now, I want to be really clear, because people will hear what I just said as an indictment of people who don't get vaccinated. It's not what I intend. People can choose not to get vaccinated for reasons of their own. But I choose to step into the gift, the miracle of that technology, the same way that I put on a seatbelt. I don't stop praying because I wear a seatbelt. I don't stop praying because I put a Band-Aid on when I get a cut. I don't stop praying and believing in God because I use the technology of modern medicine. I believe the technology of modern medicine is an extension of the divine here on earth, the highest and the best thinking of man. Is it perfect? Of course not. It's created by man. But it is a glimpse, a glimmer, an expression of divinity. You know, Charles and Myrtle, who started Unity, Charles and Myrtle Fillmore, used the power of mind to heal. But they also used medicine. They were not anti-science. So there's an opportunity to do both, folks, to step into this and to change our perspective, to change our perspective and say, that's fine. You all need to go forward in the way that's best for you. But we are also going to do what's best for us and as a community. The city of San Francisco, Unity of San Francisco, are aligning with that. And we step forward to change what is into what could be. Right? We cannot keep going forward as things have been. Obviously, look at us where we are right now. We cannot keep doing politics. We cannot keep doing COVID. We cannot keep doing life like we've been doing it. This is a wake-up call that I'm hearing, that I'm seeing, that I want to find a way to help us all step into. So it is time for a new beginning. It is time for a new understanding. It is time to let go of what we have been and become who we're really here to be. Huh. Who are you here to be? No one would answer, well, I'm here to be the watchdog. I might be wrong. Anyone here to be the watchdog? The rule keeper of life? My guess is that who you're really here to be is something that lights you up, that shines from within you, that thing that keeps you up at night. I was listening to a podcast this morning, and it talked about nostalgia. Do you ever long for the good old days? And this podcast talked about nostalgia this way. Nostalgia is a way of our mind telling us that there's something missing. Because the past is always romanticized. We forget the pain, and we romanticize how fabulous it was back then. But what that nostalgic longing is telling us is you need some more of that in your life, whether it's laughter or friendship or love and hugs and affection, that you need some more of that. I need a change, as Misa sang right now. I am changing. I've been through the darkness. I'm done with the dark night of the soul. And I'm here to say I'm going to change. I'm going to shift this. I'm going to step up. So right now, I know we all do this, because I'm one of us. We all think there's something that can't shift. We think there's something that's intractable, that is just the way it is, and it's never going to be different, right? If anyone doesn't think that, I really want to meet you, so hang out and talk to me after. But there is some parts of our life where we all feel that. And the great spiritual journey is to eradicate those one by one. To be really open to being wrong. To being wrong about other people and about situations. So that we can be cracked open. We can see that God, the infinite universe, always is here to provide good. So there's something that is really aching to come forward right now. In your life and in the world. Are you ready? Are you ready to be the vessel, the blank canvas, the possibility for it to grow and to manifest? You're ready to be the butterfly that comes out of the chrysalis? Faith is knowing a different outcome is always possible. Faith isn't a belief into a specific deity. Faith is not a belief in some doctrine or event from the past. Faith is about what you hold in your heart, in your mind, in your very being that knows no matter what is going on right now, this is not the end. JD loves this one when I say it. It's like, it always works out in the end. If it's not worked out, it is not the end, right? So I can know in the moment that this thing, this situation, this person, this me is causing the pain, is I'm feeling the pain of unacceptance of what is. Faith is knowing there's another way, there's another outcome. And it's up to me. It's up to each and every one of you at home, here, and around the globe, whenever you're listening to this, to be the change, to shift your understanding, to shift your calcified places and loosen up those joints and step into infinite possibility. To step in faith to what's coming on.